Hello and welcome to another video tutorial from ComputerGuardGuard.com. This tutorial will look at how to create a fire evacuation plan within Visio 2010. Now we're going to create this by drawing a floor plan and then by adding in some kind of symbols of interest into it to create a fire evacuation plan. This stencil for the kind of symbols of interest is only available within the professional version of Visio 2010. They are not available in the standard version by default, so you may wish to check which version of Visio that you have. But here I've started up Visio 2010. It is asking me what template I wish to use to begin my drawing, and I'm going to go for the maps and floor plans category, at which point they will give me the full list of templates within here. And I've got to go for a floor plan. As you may know, we can add stencils into other templates and other drawings, so you don't necessarily have to use the floor plan, although obviously it is, you know, perfectly set up really for this type of drawing. And I'm going to click create. Now these types of drawings, normally we talk about using a drawing scale to get the exact measurements. For a kind of fire escape plan, we're not going to worry about that. The brilliance is in its simplicity. We don't want that level of detail. We'll actually work against it. We want it to be really easy to provide moments of clarity when there is chaos, so we can glance up, see which direction they've got ahead or where the nearest fire extinguisher is, and that's what they need to know. They don't need to know where the nearest sink is or how wide the door is, this kind of stuff, which you can do in drawings of other natures. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to bring in the kind of structure of our floor plan. Over to our left we can see I've got a stencil for the walls, shell and structure. I'm just going to quickly put together, now it's only going to be a few minutes this video, so please don't judge me on how good this drawing is going to be, but I'm just going to drag the room shape over and just draw a kind of room shape. It's going to be like rectangle sort of size. Now I'm just going to quickly start dragging in some walls to build the internal structure of this. As I drag them in, you see the red squares appear. You can resize these walls. I can grab its edge to spin it round and rotate it. You see they glue, see that red square? Glues to connection point and glues over there. So it's really easy to put together the rough internal structure of this room. Here we go, let's drag it over. So a really large room here. I think I misjudged that, but that could be a really large room. And we've got another room here. I've got a basic idea in my head. I've got a picture of a building that I've done many training in before here. As I draw this, this room comes out here. It's a very thin room. So we're building this internal structure. You know, once you've got these walls in place, you want to start adding windows and doors. So I know the exit door is here. It actually swings this way into that room. Drag that round. You know, and I'm not sure how important this is, really. Once again, you're talking about the simplicity of it, but you could add doors to these other rooms. Let's add them in. You see they're just cut into the wall as you do so. And it's possible to resize these doors and stuff. I might make that a little bit bigger. This is the main door out. And then we've got a kind of corridor here. So I'm just going to drag these walls in. And the actual fire exit, the nearest fire exit when you're on this floor, this building, is a window here, which leads to an outside staircase. That's our nearest exit. So you know if you're in this room, you've got to jump out. You've got to dash around to here, through this door and out into the exit. So we have the kind of basic structure here. We've got an outside wall and then some internal structure of doors, windows and walls. The next step really to turn it into a fire escape plan is to go to our points of interest stencil over on this left, where we can add in the more important aspects here. First of all, where the fire exit is. We can drag this exit symbol to show that this is the nearest exit. Make it a little bit bigger, a bit easier to spot. And as I look around, we've also got a fire extinguisher. We which is by the door over here. And further down, see there's tons of good stencils here for other types of drawings. We're going for the fire alarm pool. The alarm is by the door here as well to alert others. Yeah, we could spend time making sure these are the same sizes, really. One way I can do that is I could select this shape and pop it to view, task panes, and bring in the size and position. I mean, there are many ways of doing this. If you used Visio a little bit before, you may have your own way. But I can see this is 1250 by 1500. Might make that 1250. Let's make it equal width. And then you can do the same to the others, 1250. Oops. Same for that one. Oh, that's high like the other one was. They're all the same size. Let's shift that up so they're equal. Getting a bit fussy now. And next up will be the fire evacuation route. We can drag in these arrows. We can create an evacuation route. And I'm just dragging that with my control and shift keys. Trying to get quick ways that... And these can be found in other tutorials, but quick ways of getting these arrows together, getting duplicates the same size. Exits out there, exits over here. So a quick rough guide of our route. And the last thing you may wish to do is add some text to this drawing. So I may want to put the room numbers so people know. You know, if they aren't reading it in a rush and they're just at the start of the day to have a look, yeah, this is our room in relation to the others. But also in situations, extra text, such as who is the fire marshal? You know, is there a drill today? Should they be expecting some kind of alarm? And we can do this by popping to our home tab and just going for our text tool here and click this text button, draw a text box in. I might go to my alignment buttons here and choose to put it in the kind of top left. Make it much larger font. And just start typing some text. So that's just, you know, the fire marshal for this floor is Sarah Jane. A fire drill is conducted every Thursday. At 10. They all seem to be Thursdays at 10 o'clock. super. And anything else, you know, the evacuation point, that should probably be the first thing, really, in here. Is outside Starbucks, opposite the main entrance. So they know where to head to. Starbucks, you can't miss them. As long as I don't get it confused with one of the others. Okay, then I'm going to just switch back to my pointer tool. That will pop out. You know, you can do some adjustments here if you wish. But we have a text. I'll probably space them out a little bit more. Yeah, you can put your company's logo up here if you want to brand this kind of stuff. But it's just a quick example of how to put together a fire evacuation plan. Yeah, it's going to be nice and simple using these points of interest to really mark out so people know where the nearest fire exit is or where the nearest alarm port is. You know, the meeting point, these kind of things. Thank you for watching. Hope you find this tutorial useful. Please check out some of our other tutorials and our other tips and our tricks at computergaga.com.